What's up guys, Ruben here, here to give you guys a new tutorial. Now this trick is more of an intermediate trick. We're gonna step out of that beginner range. You can do boards, you can do back lips. You're gonna jump into this trick, which is my favorite trick, board back lips. You're just basically putting those two together. We're gonna be doing it today on the new transformer rails. This is a longer version of the rails. So basically, board back lip, you're gonna be jumping on your backside board slide midway through the rail, hop up, and jump into a back lip. Now, a lot of you kids think this trick is really hard to do. It's not really that hard to do. If you can do board slides, you can do back lips, it should come to you pretty easy. So just for the sake, I'm gonna do a board slide for you guys, and I'm gonna do a back lip for you guys as well. So this is my backside board slide. Next thing we're gonna do is the back lip slide. Now, if you're not too good at the back lips yet, you can just do the end of the rail for right now, because that's really what you're just gonna be doing with the board back lip. You're gonna be grinding more of a backside board slide, and then halfway or 3/4 of the way is when you can decide to jump into the back lip. To start off, step by step, board back lips are a hard trick to get the hold of, but once you get the motion of it, it's pretty easy to do. So usually what I tell my friends, just to give them tips, you wanna learn how to back board slide and pop over. So I'll show you guys what I mean really quick. You wanna be able to hop over the rail. You can do it at the middle of the rail, at the end of the rail, you just wanna be able to get that motion to hop over. Once you got that motion, you can decide to keep practicing that till you get it down, or just start going into the board back lip. Now it is scary to just get your whole body twisted midway through the rail and just start sliding again after you just hopped up, but if you full commitment, just straight full commitment, you should be able to get it. This is one of those tricks where if you don't really commit all the way, you can fall and hurt yourself pretty bad. I've done it, trust me. With every trick, you gotta fully commit or it could go wrong. Again, you can do backside board slide, go to the middle of the rail, do back lip, or go about 3/4 of the rail and then jump into the back lip just to kiss the back lip at the end, just to get the hold of it. I'll show you guys a quick board back lip. Just like you saw, I did the back board slide. Just as I was about to get to the end, decided to do the back lip. That's one way you guys can start doing it. That's how I did it. Just practice board sliding as much as I could. Even if it was the end of the rail, just by kissing it. Easy to do, just jump into that back lip. Don't be scared. And then as you keep progressing and practicing this trick, you can do a less back board slide, more back lip. Once you guys get the hold of this trick, you guys can start doing tricks into it, tricks out of it. So this is one of the problems I see when I see kids trying to do board back lips. They commit fully on the board slide. Once they go to the back lip, their legs start to flail and they just get all wonky on the rail. That's one thing you don't want to do, because once you jump into the back lip and you're not really committed, you can really fall by getting stuck in the head tube like this, by going over like this and falling down on your face. One way that you can really avoid this is, first, fully commitment. Remember, always full commitment or nothing. If you prepare your body for the back lip when you're doing the board slide, it'll basically come easier to you by jumping and getting already in that back lip motion. You're gonna wanna already have your back lips down the way you do it, goofy, regular, switch maybe, but I don't know if you guys do switch. Once you already have that motion of how you want to back lip, just try and add that to your stance for your back board slides. And once you're halfway about the rail, you can just hop over. This is one thing you guys really want to do. Make sure your back board is on top of the rail. You don't want to be doing a back board like this, like this, like this. That's not a backboard. This is a backboard slide. Once you hop into the back lip, it's okay to start off by landing like this just to get the hold of it. But make sure as you keep practicing this trick that you want to keep turning that back lip more and more. Only because it's going to be easier for you, believe it or not. You might think that going to this is easy. That's really sketchy. It's not. I mean, because you could easily slip out, get stuck right here. It could go so many ways wrong that you guys wouldn't want to. So like I said, get that back lip way more out like that. But yeah, let me show you guys a quick board back lip again. Maybe throw a trick out, maybe throw a trick in. The main thing about this trick is your position, your stance, because if you do a good, decent back board, but your back lip is all floppy, man, you're gonna fall. That's not gonna be good. If it helps you guys. It helps me sometimes if I'm doing it on a big rail. I just mess around on the floor and go like that. You don't wanna backboard and then hop in the back lip and your feet go slipping off. You wanna make sure your stance is proper, smooth, set in stone, because if it's not and you end up backboarding and backlipping with your foot slipping off, you're just gonna go. And that's not gonna be good, especially if it's on a down rail. You definitely wanna have this trick good if you're doing it on a down rail, even if it's like a four stair down rail. But yeah, guys, let me show you one more. That pretty much does it, guys. I'm Ruben Rodriguez from The Vault. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, follow us on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. Don't forget to buy one of my shirts. I'll see you guys next time.